I am attending this sort of seminar for the first time, and it is mainly for the entrepreneur. And we have some entrepreneur we brought this time for of the categories, the garments and the leather goods and other embroidery stitches. And the belt and the belt and road, this is in short the obor. The obor is China's effort initiative to foster global trade and economic development with Chinese characteristics, with an open framework. And rather than a foreign aid program or melting a network of trading routes, is a new economic roadmap through greater connectivity realized enough through massive infrastructure of the development. I'm feeling very good because last month I went to China. There was also that was also organized by the Chinese. They One Belt One Road, and that was mainly on the business and the machineries, that sort of thing. They're focused on that thing. But this is mainly for the women and the entrepreneurs, how they can, how can they survive, how can they do better, that is the focus. And in respect of that, if we say the Belt and Road Initiative has attention and support from the international community since it was proposed by President Xi Jinping in 2013. Now the initiative has been conducted theoretically to practically encompassing communication cooperation on policy, facility, trade, finance and culture, and civil exchanges in cultural heritage stands as an indispensable part of the cooperation. Regarding our Bangladesh, we can say that in Bangladesh, garments industries are flourishing more and more. And through that garments industries, the rural women are in condition of taking the responsibility of their livelihood. They can earning money, and they're educated their children, and they're improving their living standards. So garments industries helped a lot. And we have about over 2.5 million women in garments industry. They are the most economic labor force. And where is the major field of attraction for the foreign investors? Famous sunset industry relocation would be done in Bangladesh, as it is providing Chinese exclusive economic zone in Chittagong area. We have the large. Therefore, the relocation industries along with such a economic women force could be saved hand in hand in glory. Now, I think that this sort of seminar should be quite often should be arranged, because there will be exchange of the ideas, views, and what kind of entrepreneurship they, if they start a business, or they can have the ideas. And you see, Bhutan is a different culture, Nepal is a different culture, Bangladesh has different culture, yet we are the South Asian countries. There is some similarities, because you know, then I can understand the Nepalese, because the dialect, the way they talk, some few words picked up from Bangla, because Sanskrit is the origin of, you know. So we have a relation through, you know, the language and understanding, body language, whatever it is. So we can have the ideas, we can grow up our women folk in Bangladesh also. Bhutan can get some ideas for our women, what can they do. So I think this Chinese effort of the Uber, One Belt, One Road, is a very good idea to unite, to improve. And you know, the women are fighting for the power. So the more we will stand, more we will stand on our foot, don't depending on the men folk. The women folk will be more stronger in thinking. You see, one thing I can say now, I don't think it's irrelevant, but you see, in the population is very much high in Bangladesh. Nowadays it's a little less, because the women has their own say that I will take my child or not. In Bangla we say amar bachcha ami nibo, that means my child I will take. Why my husband will force me to take this? This is the independence, and this is the self-confidence they have.
This is also a revolution.
Because they know, why should I produce so much children if I cannot grow them properly, not to grow, give them proper education, why should I? And you know, regarding the election, to whom they will give the vote, it was also directed by the men. Now they have the say, you know. No, I know who will be the best for the country. So this is the great achievement, I think.